Drop a like and subscribe in the next 5 seconds, or when you go to witness the Galactus live event, the servers sadly will be full. The Fortnite Nexus War is upon us as the Devourer of Worlds is about to make a stand in the distance and arrive on our Fortnite island. As we're less than 24 hours away now, with us seeing this timer on the helicarrier in-game, in lobby and battle pass tab, it's safe to say we're not safe now, and as we've prepared with the helicarrier not only being fueled but started, it doesn't take a genius to know that the tensions are high now in the world of Fortnite for our characters and superheroes. With this being one of the biggest live events we've ever seen in Fortnite history, ending off the season and even shutting off the servers once again like we saw in the end event going into the black hole, and with this being confirmed by the leaked cinematic of when we try to log on after the event occurs, I figured in today's video we'd go over everything ranging from the event itself, obviously everything that we know now up until it in advance that will only be what we know until it happens anyways, and then of course how this directly links into or is continued in the season 5 trailer, as again it specifies right here that yes, whatever happens is to be concluded or continued in the next season. This is literally the last video before season 5, so do yourself and me a favour, stick around and watch the full thing, because I guarantee you guys, there's last minute details in here that nobody knows about. And quickly before we go any further, I just want to remind you guys that 70% of you are actually missing out on the opportunity of being gifted a season 5 battle pass for completely free, as I gift 5 subscribers every single day. As of right now, I can't gift the battle pass considering it's before the season releases, but here's me gifting 5 cosmetics from the item shop, and here's what I gifted yesterday, or the last video I posted. If you do want to receive a gift, become like the 30% and subscribe to the channel right now with all notifications turned on, and then comment your Epic Games ID down below so perhaps I can gift you or show me doing so in the next video. And even if you don't want a gift, hey, we're incredibly close to 2.1 million. We're aiming for that by the end of the year as we enter December. I'm getting nervous that this won't happen, so yeah, make sure it does. And don't forget, in time for season 5, make sure, of course, you've entered code FriendlyMachine inside the Fortnite item shop, as although you don't need to enter the code to enter any giveaways like that, the more people that support the code, I can then use the funds to gift more of you guys, so I'm just saying, it's a win-win for everybody. And what's that, Peely? If they don't watch until the end of this video, their game's gonna crash during the live event. Oh my god, I wouldn't risk it, guys. Yeah, make sure you're watching until the end. Okay, so the first thing to mention, which is a common misconception, is the fact that Galactus doesn't exactly want to just destroy us as Fortnite characters. Rather so, he's simply visiting the Fortnite world as he wants to harness the power of the Zero Point, as it's the same dimension, just reorganized matter, as Donald Mustard described in this Marvel podcast. Funnily enough, this is kind of like what we saw in season 9 with, you know, the Polar Peak monster and the mecha robot, ironically being called the Devourer, the Polar Peak monster in itself, as we can tell from the skin from the Polar Legends pack. And believe it or not, many people have actually forgotten that initially we didn't want to harness the power of the Zero Point on the mecha team leader's side of protecting the Fortnite island or realm. Who initially started it was this big beast way before the event even occurred, from visiting the island multiple times and leaving foot imprint marks. However, it was only in this event itself where, yes, the Zero Point was harnessed or destabilized above the Earth's crust and used to then defeat the Polar Peak monster itself. And I'm just saying, everybody thought Thanos was the big bad guy in the Marvel series anyways, or from Marvel overall, especially with the integration in Fortnite with him being quite a big character. Well, we haven't seen anything yet until the Devourer of Worlds arrives, as we can not only tell from the size overall of the Devourer of Worlds, but what we need to do in order to defend our island from having its Zero Point harnessed in this reorganized dimension. And just before we go over exactly what we'll be able to do during the event, this particular teaser in itself on the news tab indicated or implied that the Zero Point is directly below the ruins or the authority or whatever you want to call it, the middle of the map. And this would make sense considering Loot Lake was kind of central on the old map, and this is where the Zero Point or the Nexus was below in itself, originally discovered in the vault in the Unvaulted event in Chapter 1 Season 8, but only came into effect in the storyline in Chapter 1 Season 9 when everything as previously mentioned went down with these two giant characters fighting together. And how we're able to tell this, despite it being a very cartoon-like or silhouette drawing or picture that Epic Games have created, is because somebody's managed to decipher that this is Risky Reels, and from looking at this angle in-game, it does directly match up to be below the ruins. And and not to mention two in the Device Live event. Hopefully this is made sense of, by the way, of what exactly happened. This in itself was an orb-like structure, potentially using power of the Zero Point, or what Midas was trying to harness, and this was directly below what once was the Agency, and then got, obviously, you know, revamped into the Authority, and then now the ruins that we're seeing ever since Fort Nightmares. And this all kind of makes sense when you look at it this way, because Galactus, being, you know, a world devourer to keep him alive, is travelling toward the Fortnite Island, and the only way to devour it completely would be to, I guess, eat the heart of it, and that is the Zero Point. And not only is it the heart of the Fortnite Island, but throughout this entire now collaborated galaxy is the centre of everything, as Donald Mustard mentioned in the Marvel podcast when talking about how long we've known, or should I say Epic have known, Galactus is travelling toward the Fortnite Island for, being ever since the matter was reorganised after the events of the end event in Chapter 2 Season 1, and with Donald Mustard confirming that everything that's happened has been connected and hopefully is made sense of, all the loose ends that we don't know about, such as where did the Mecha Robot go, what happened to the island, or where is the Zero Point, and so much more. If it wasn't already enough proof that the Zero Point does reside under our Fortnite Island in Chapter 2, from him talking about Galactus wanting to devour, well, this being the centre of everything, he changed his Twitter bio from the Helicarrier to the Zero Point, and had his banner showcasing or symbolising the final fight, as I'm guessing being a small teaser of what's to come in the comic book form that we've been seeing a large theme of in this season itself, and that we can still view but is to be continued, as you can see. And speaking of the to be continued section, this then was set to his banner of Galactus himself on this final page, and now has recently been changed yet again a day before the event to this. And if we connect the dots of what's implied or presented here together, the fact that his banner now is Galactus flying toward us, or the Fortnite world with us superheroes and Fortnite characters on it, and that his bio is the Zero Point, meaning this is what he's ultimately flying toward, and with them teasing over social media that yes, he hungers for the Zero Point and wants to devour it basically, I don't think it could be any more clear of what's going to be going down during this event in terms of the intention of Galactus himself and where exactly the focus of this event will be. Not to mention too that previously Donald Mustard had his location set to the Helicarrier, and as you guys may or may not know, as I showed at the start of the video, this not only has the event timer on, ticking away from the final hours now at the time of me recording this video, but has started up as if it's going to fly over the map, which data miners also concluded will be the case, and will be able to go on during the event itself to stop Galactus from devouring this Fortnite world or universe. And although there's still mysteries such as what was Nick Fury his eye patch doing on here, and will we be seeing more Marvel characters such as himself make an appearance during the event that we haven't seen as skins rotate throughout the item shop yet, and perhaps the bigger question being what's in this vault, or will we be able to get inside it with a specific key card exclusive only to this event? Well, I guess we're yet to know, but Kumar over on Twitter had an insane theory of one of the seven being inside here once it's opened, or we open it ourselves. And again, this correlates back to the tweet Donald Mustard stated at the start of the season, Chapter 2, Season 4, that it's all connected, not just the Marvel Universe now, but our Fortnite lore. And despite us only knowing three of the seven, being the Scientist, the Visitor, and Paradigm, hopefully we're revealed to the four others during this event, or perhaps the other three, considering one sacrificed themselves by flying into the Zero Point itself at the end of the end event. And let's not forget about Agent Jonesy, considering his files were recently updated, so it looks like, as we saw him make an appearance very subtly in the Device Live event in this office location, this further backs up we're going to be seeing another appearance from him, and perhaps explaining more of his purpose, but in the Devourer of Worlds live event. And then finally, as a conclusion to all of this, with everything hopefully being made sense of or happening, exactly what will be happening in the LTM itself when we're fighting Galactus, as confirmed by the description of this that Epic Games have been teasing, we're going to be driving the battle bus, if it wasn't already blatantly obvious. Not only have Epic Games asked us several times if we'll be able to drive the battle bus, but even people are speculating Agent John Jones or Jonesy will say this over the phone from the office location to us, the Fortnite players, as we heard him talk during the Device Live event again. But furthermore, Fortnite have even shown us the purpose for driving the battle bus, which is to actually fend off Galactus with these gamma cells that have recently been upgraded or attached to it from Tony Stark's plan coming into play from this whiteboard. And considering these plans came true, who knows what this actually meant on the other one at the small shack before Stark Industries was even pulled into the Fortnite Island, but I guess we'll have to wait and and see. Either way, just know the event itself is going to be completely huge, because not only have we already had leaked the ultimate theme of the next season being Star Wars or The Mandalorian, as The Mandalorian is the secret integrated battle pass or weekly unlockable skin, and this was revealed because of the fact Fortnite's new monthly subscription called The Crew, a new bundle was leaked, and then Fortnite announced the trailer showing a certain backbling, perhaps foreshadowing in advance what's going to be happening to the Fortnite planet, which is implied again based off the scale of this event. Not only that, but the red kind of beam substance going around it that the Gorgeous shoot out, and I'm guessing Galactus does too. And to further back all of this up, that this is true or has been right in front of our eyes this entire time, teasing what's upcoming or the aftermath of everything once the servers do go back online after we enter this offline black hole state again, Mark Rain, one of the lead Epic Games directors or creative community managers or something like that, stated that if he had one word to describe this next season, it would be chaotic. Kind of like what we saw in Season 5 of Chapter 1 with the Worlds Collide theme, and I'm guessing this is going to be making a forefront appearance again, the Rift Zones, and so many unusual things coming into the Fortnite world in Chapter 2, but for this next season now, Season 5 again. And just before we end off the video now, a small Easter egg that's still to be determined is the Galactus skin himself, if we'll be able to get him at some point, whether he'll rotate throughout the item shop, be included in the Season 5 Battle Pass as one of the skins, although we've only had three confirmed as of now on the art asset, once we load up the game with Season 5's update live. And hopefully, considering data miners have managed to pull it into the locker and made him do emotes such as, ironically, planetary vibe, considering he's not vibing with the planets, rather so he's come to destroy it. Fingers crossed this still leaves room for Galactus being in the item shop or in some way, shape or form obtainable, but let me know what you guys think of that, and also what your predictions are for the event in the comment section down below, from a scale of 1 being the worst and 10 being the best live event we've ever seen or are going to see. And as the title states, right now we're going to be ending off the video with Sardar Concepts trailer in preparation of the event itself, and just to give you guys an insight as to how hype this has made people across the community who've seen it, well, let's just say it's had over 1.4 or 5 million views. So yeah, really cool trailer, he'll be linked in the video description down below. And with that said, before you go today, slap a like in the video, make sure you're subscribing to the channel. And with that said, sit back, relax, and enjoy this Galactus event hype trailer.
Your world has survived many battles, but it won't survive the war that is upon you. Now a mere light year from this feeble place you call home. The end is near. And this time, it is inevitable. The sun will rise for the last time, and the world will take its last breath. In your own hands.